distribution of megasporangia and microsporangia in the strobilus of Selaginella. First example we may take is where in the strobilus megasporangia are basal, that they are at the base of the strobilus, and microsporangia are apical in position. How will this be? Suppose on the other side, microsporangia, and this side bears only megasporangia. So this is seen in Selaginella in equifolium. Now we come to the next type. The fourth type of arrangement of megasporangia and microsporangia in strobilus of Selaginella are where the sporangia. Now the sporangia words means both microsporangia and megasporangia. So the sporangia are non-functional at the base of strobilus. So this is seen in Selaginella Selaginoids, where a series of sporangia. So, series of sporangia, which may be either microsporangia or megasporangia, they are non-functional at the base of the strobilus. So, this is seen in Selaginella selaginoids. So, here you can see that if this is the strobilus, like this. So, the basal sporangia are non-functional or abortive, and the fertile sporangia are towards the top of the strobilus. Now let's come to the fifth type of arrangement. In the fifth type, there is no definite arrangement of microsporangia and megasporangia in the strobilus. This is seen in Selaginella grassmartensi and Selaginella coalescence. So these are two examples of Selaginella, those species of Selaginella where there is no definite arrangement of microsporangia and megasporangia in the strobilus. Species. Okay, so this distribution you have been able to see. One thing which I told you already, that they are heterosporous, they are dimorphic in arrangement, isn't it? And bisporangiate means where one plant has male strobilus, other plant has female strobilus. So the one which has male strobilus will form all microsporophylls. There will be an aggregation of microsporophylls, and all microsporophylls will be a microsporangia. And all female strobili will be a megasporophylls, and each megasporophyll will be a megasporangium. So there will be many megasporangia. This is seen in Selaginella gracilis and Selaginella acromegalis. There will be a dash here. These are examples of bisporangiate strobili present. So you should remember all these arrangements. We will continue with the reproduction by spores in the next class. Thank you.